Almost everything nowadays has a diet version, such as Diet Coke, Diet Pasta, Diet Pizza, which promise a similar flavors to the real things without the drawback, mainly calorie. Sugar substitutes, which can be found on the label of a number of items, are one way for manufacturers to make their product diet-friendly without the drawback. But why isn't there any fat substitute? Wait, there might be one. Let's find out what it is with PAA. Hi, I'm Chaozhe Lo. Welcome to What People Also Ask, where I search something seemingly obvious on Google and share with you some of its spot, aka People Also Ask, which is a feature telling you what other people are searching on Google that relates to your query. Today's keyword is Olestra, a fat substitute created by P&G. We will discuss what it is and why it is not as popular as a sugar substitute. So let's start with our first part. Does Olestra mimic the true fat? The answer to this question is extracted from an article titled The Chemistry of Fat Substitutes, published by a Discover magazine, which is an American science magazine launched in October 1980 by Time Incorporated and has been owned by Kalmbach Publishing since 2010. According to this article, a typical fat consists of two parts, a backbone of glycerol, a type of alcohol linked to three long-tailed hydrocarbons called fatty acids, which vary in type depending on the fat. Lipases, a type of enzyme found in intestine, have evolved over millennia to split two fatty acids, leaving truncated molecules small enough to pass through the intestinal wall. In Olestra, however, the glycerol has been replaced by a sucrose molecule, a sugar which has enough free arms to attach to 8 fatty acids. Lipases cannot clamp onto such a large particle, so Olestra passes unscathed through the intestines. Olestra tastes like fat, but contains in effect no usable calorie, and two studies, both funded by Prater and Gamble, suggesting that consuming it can be helpful for those with high cholesterol or heart problems. One of the studies indicates that people who eat Olestra can reduce the cholesterol level by more than 10%. The other study found a more than 10% increase in blood flow to the heart among people who just eaten Olestra-filled banana muffin. Here I want you to notice two things. First, the article mentioned these researches were published in 2001, so they are very old studies that might be outdated. Second, these studies were funded by P&G, which is the exact company that was trying to commercialize Olestra. So I will take these findings with a grain of salt. So let's talk about its controversy in our next part. Can we digest Olestra? Google's auto-generated answer is linked to an article titled Olestra Controversy, published by the Canadian Encyclopedia, which is a national encyclopedia of Canada, published online by the Toronto-based historical organization Historica Canada. And another article titled Olestra Eater, Be Aware, published by WebMD. According to these two articles, Olestra might soak up and eliminate essential vitamins and nutrients. It may also cause fluctuations and diarrhea because, well, if fat cannot be absorbed by the body, it has to go somewhere eventually. But in 1996, despite strong objections by nutritionists and consumer advocates, the United States Food and Drug Administration approved Olestra for use in salty snacks and crackers, provided they carry a label warning consumers of potential digestive upset. Reporting in the February 15, 2000 issues in the Annals of Internal Medicine, a research team led by Ranga Balaskara, MD, also found that people who regularly consume Olestra-containing potato chips may test false positive for steatorrhea because they are likely to have high amount of fat in their feces due to the unique chemical composition of Olestra, leading to expensive and unnecessary tests. So here's the question, is Olestra still used? Google's auto-generated answer is linked to an article titled 6 foods that are legal in the United States but banned in other countries, published by Insider in 2017. According to this article, since Olestra has been linked to gastrointestinal disease in children, terrible diarrhea in adults, and has also been found to increase appetite, completely negating its potential fat-free benefits, it's banned in Canada and European countries. But you might find Olestra sometimes refers to its brand name Olean in American food. I just never saw one personally. I wonder where can I find one. Today we learn what Olestra is, the potential risk of using it, and why it's so controversial. If you made it to the end of the video, chances are that you enjoy learning what people also ask on Google. But let's face it, reading PAA yourself will be a pain. So here's the deal. I will do a reading for you and upload a video compiling some fun PAA once a week. All you have to do is to hit the subscribe button and the bell icon so you won't miss any PAA report that I compile. So just do it right now. Bye!